guys, it's me, Carmen, aka the Wooden Poet, and this is actually like a video response slash some questions for you guys. Okay, his real name is Kareem. He's a young man from Canada, and he basically was saying that, you know, a lot of times we make life more complicated than it is, and and life is a very simple thing. I'm paraphrasing, and I mean, I've gotten it wrong, but I interpret it as this, that he's saying that we live and our youth, we deal with that, then we start our education and we get married and grow old and have our children and grow old with our spouses. And, you know, that we should, there's a couple of things we could do to make our lives more simple. And he made a lot of good points about taking care of yourself, and which is something I need to do more of. I know this, I admit this, but it's my struggle and I need to work on it. He also mentioned taking care of your soul, in keeping moving and taking up hobbies and whatnot. So I agree with all that, but, however, having taught special education and having met young people whose lives were anything but simple, not everybody can do that. Some people have some severe emotional baggage. Some people, if you have a mental illness, it's like a demon within, and those of you who share that with me, no. I'm not saying that my life's complicated because of it. I'm not saying that I can't make it simplified. I can. I have. But it's not always that easy. I've known young people who've had to deal with things like, I had a student once, and it was way back. I'm not going to tell you exactly where or anything because, you know, confidentiality. I had a student who, his mother tried to pour gasoline over him and kill him. And, you know, I think people just pick up. When I think about that, I realize how lucky I am. When I think about the student I had who, whose father was also his grandfather. Kid that I absolutely loved and adored. I mean, I loved that kid. And this kid was like, he would bring me apples, and then he found out I didn't like red apples, I liked yellow apples. I tried to not let him know, but somehow he figured it out. And then he started bringing me dandelions, and I tried not to sneeze in front of him, but I was allergic to him. So he ended up bringing me pine cones, because I love the smell of pine, and my desk was completely filled with it. I think this was like my second year of teaching. That was my first teaching job. And he would look at me and say, Miss Carmen, I love ooh. I mean, this kid wanted attention so bad that he actually one day cut up his own book bag and admitted it to it. In the end, what happened was very sad. Probably sadder than if he had died. Someone came to me and said that the younger sister in that family had been molested and raped, and they were saying it was him. And he had gotten into a fight with several boys who were also coming to my classroom, because I was a resource teacher. And he came in and admitted, just basically said, so if I did, there's nothing you could do about it. And said that to me, and my heart just broke in a million pieces. And I don't see, you know, yeah, his life is never going to be simple. And after that, you know, her life is never going to be simple after that. And you know, and it goes in the, I'm not going to go into details because, you know, the family, the mother's life was never simple. Yes, some people out there do make their lives more complicated than it has to be. They fret over little things. They fret over bad traffic and people talking in the movies, which is annoying. I'm not going to deny that. That's annoying, those things. But there's a bigger picture. There's something that you need to look at, you know. Not everybody's life is simple. And I'm just telling you the milder stories. I'm not even telling you the stories of when I was a wilderness camp teacher, because I really can't. Life is not always simple for everybody, and there are some things you can do. So with that in mind, I wanted to ask you guys some questions. I bring up my little treasure chest here. This is neat. My sister gave this to me for Mother's Day. When I lived in Germany, I actually went to Paris. So, Mary gave me this. And I keep my crafts. And it's because every time I don't, my husband throws them away. Because it gets everywhere. And I make things like... Let me show you. That's a good shot. It's a necklace I made. My last hobby is making things. I've made wreaths. I don't have any wreaths to show you. I made really pretty ones for my sister for Christmas. And every year I kind of choose things. I've done tie-dye t-shirts. What else have I made? Christmas ornaments, of course, that's, you know. I'm better at the year. Little braiding. I'm supposed to get into knitting and crocheting. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that, but I might do that. I might ask my mom to help me get the stuff, but yeah. So right now it's jewelry making. Poetry and YouTube are my hobbies when I can do them, or sometimes I'm quite busy. So does this dad. I find different ways. You know, to me, spirituality is so much more than just religion. It's so much more than believing in a certain thing. It's living that. And sometimes it's hard to live that. And it's... Spirituality can go so much further. Wow, I think that's a good one. Than just, the, you know, do you believe in God? Do you believe in Jesus? Do you have a spiritual path? I know some people who were atheists and are more spiritual than a lot of believers. So, how do you take care of yourself spiritually? I do this through poetry, I do this through reading, I do this through prayer. I haven't really done meditation, I used to meditate. Third question, this is what I really need help with, is because I don't really think I do this very often. I don't take care of myself enough. Take care of everybody else before I take care of myself. So how do you do that? Because I need to start doing that. And I want to say that to you guys because then I'm going to have to. But